One thing that I've seen consistently with the students that I take out for like live training and coaching is that they have trouble generating interest and maintaining interest right off the bat. And a lot of guys will call this, they'll call this hooking the set. And I don't really like to use those pickup terms, but how do you generate that interest right off the bat and maintain that interest? Because a lot of times they'll just talk to the girl for a little bit, and then the conversation will eventually die out, and then they'll kind of come back to me and wonder what happened. But when I would talk to these girls, the girls would be interested. A lot of times they would follow us around, and you know, some of them were even asking for my number and stuff like that. So what was going on? What was I doing differently than them? Well, I know exactly what I was doing differently than them because I used to have this problem too. So I get guys that are better looking than me, and I get guys that are worse looking than me. But consistently across the board, what they weren't doing that I was doing is they weren't providing enough value. When you come into an interaction, you need to provide value, and that's why a girl keeps talking to you, whatever shape or form that takes. So start asking yourself that question: how can I provide value to these interactions? And it can be a little bit tough at the beginning. She doesn't really know much about you. She doesn't know where you come or what you do. So how do you provide value right off the bat? Well, the easiest way, or the best way, is to be fun. Okay? Provide fun. When people go out, that's the number one thing that they're trying to do. Women are trying to have fun when they go out. You know, that's the number one thing. You know, sometimes they're trying to find a guy as well, but fun still comes first. And fun should be the first thing that you're going after as well. So a lot of times I'll get guys that will be in a position, they're like, oh, I don't know what to do. I don't know what the next step is. They'll reach a point in the conversation where they run out of things to say, or they just get kind of, feels kind of awkward, or there's a dead silence, and then they just kind of like back up, and they're just like, all right, well, it was nice to meet you, and then they leave. Okay, when you're in that situation, don't ask yourself, what's the next step? Ask yourself, what would be fun for the both of us? And then you start asking yourself that question more and more. You start figuring out, what are some fun things to do while you're out? Okay, in the nightlife or at bars and stuff like that, there's tons of options. I've been doing this for a long time, so I know what I like to do. I know what's fun. And so I can answer this question pretty easily, and I'm providing that right off the bat. Now, there's a number of different ways that you can provide fun for people really quickly on the interaction. First of all, you can just provide, just by coming in with a little bit of enthusiasm, can go a long way. Providing humor, making funny jokes. One of my favorite things to do is I love teasing. I love teasing people. I love making fun of other people that are around us. And so that provides a game. That provides enjoyment, laughter. All of these things are good. All of these things are valuable when you're trying to have a good time when you're out. Most people are bored, honestly, when they're just sitting there. Okay, so these things can definitely help. Also, being interested in what they have to say, having interesting conversations is good too. So being a good talker can definitely help with this. And I'm a great talker. But this doesn't compare to the next point that I'm going to make, which is knowing your area, knowing fun activities to do at the bar that you're at, or knowing cool places to go. That is going to be the ultimate value provider right there. That's something that girls aren't going to be able to have, especially if they're visiting, especially if they don't know the area that well and you know the area. That is some real value that you can provide right off the bat. The bar that we were at over the weekend had like an arcade in the background. It had an arcade in the back. It had like pinball machines, it had like a Miss Pac-Man set. It had some shooter game. It had that. It had a dance floor. It had a photo booth, which, you know, maybe not right away, but photo booth is cool later. It had an area where you could sit down. You can come be my friends. There is a bunch of fun stuff that those, if I'm talking to a group of girls, that they can do with us. If they're just standing there wondering what to do, I got plenty of fun, awesome options. Who wouldn't want to come with that? Who wouldn't want a fun experience to go with? And that is going to separate you from 99% of the guys out there. Because sure, you can be a guy who, you know, if you think you're good looking or whatever, you think you're funny, but there's going to be other guys that are, you know, probably good looking and funny too. What you can provide is provide a fun experience. That's what most guys don't know how to do, and they're kind of clueless when they're out. So if you know this, you know your area, you know where all the fun stuff are, then you can lead people to do those fun things. And people are going to follow you because they're trying to have fun too. So a lot of times I would get these girls not only interested, but I would get them to follow me around. And then they see me leading. They see me leading the group. They see me taking them to all these fun places. They feel an enjoyment and a good experience when they're hanging out with me. Like, no wonder a lot of them were attracted to me when we were doing this sort of thing. And I wasn't able to do this at first because I wasn't asking myself that question about how to have fun. You need to develop skills to be able to enjoy yourself when you're out. And once you start doing this, a lot of this pickup, you know, A lot of these pickup step-by-step things that you're following that are like making your brain hurt, a lot of them are going to go away. Your results are going to go up and you're going to be a lot happier when you go out too. Trust me. So if when it comes time to figure out what to do, like let's say a perfect example is like the end of the night. Let's say you're talking to some girls, sounds like they're interested, they're attracted to you, but 2 a.m. rolls around, bar's closing up. What do you do? You're basically your only option is to try and you think your only option is maybe to bring them back to your place, but they're not ready yet. They don't know you well enough. They want to keep partying or they want to have some more good times. There's plenty of options that I have available. Like there's usually a diner down the street that we can go eat at. There's usually a couple after parties that I know about. You know, we can go back to my place, play some board games, have a couple drinks or something like that. I have fun shit planned. And that's why people stick around and hang out with me. And that's why I was able to create interest and keep the interest going right off the bat. So that's what I would invite you guys to do is remember, when you're going out, people are trying to have fun. So learn how to be a fun person when you're out. Okay. Ask yourself that question. Not what is the next step? Ask yourself what would be fun for the both of us to do. And know the areas that you're going out into. Like look at if you're at a bar or if you're at a party or something like that, look for fun stuff to do. Find out what you like to do, what's enjoyable for you. Because, you know, a lot of the rule when it comes to dating is whatever you feel, she feels. Then you're going to be able to give her a better experience. You're going to have a lot more fun. She's going to have a lot more fun too. She's going to be a lot more attracted to you because of it. So that's all I have to say about this, you guys. If you made it to the end, consider subscribing. I come out with videos like this every single week. If you have any questions that you'd like me to answer, put them in the comment section below or shoot me an email. If you're interested in my mentorship program, shoot me an email to thesingleguy2017@gmail.com. Thanks a lot, you guys. Good luck out there.